Hi, this is Dr. A, and let's go over the signs and symptoms and pathologies that are related to the muscular system. All right, let's start with the signs and symptoms. So adhesion is scar tissue in the fascia. It makes muscle movement difficult, makes the person stiff. Atonia is a lack of muscle tone. Atrophy is poor muscle development, the result of muscle disease or lack of use, so it's like if somebody's bedbound. It's also referred to as muscle wasting. Bradykinesia is having slow movements. Contracture is an abnormal shortening of the muscle fibers, tendons, or fascia, and it tends, so then they tend to be in a contracted kind of position. Dyskinesia is having difficult or abnormal movements. So if you had like shaking or something like that, so that was a tremor, that would be a type of dyskinesia. Dystonia is having abnormal muscle tone. Hyperkinesia is having an excessive amount of movement. Hypertonia is having excessive muscle tone. Hypertrophy is an increase in muscle bulk from use, which is kind of the goal of bulking up for muscle, you know, trying to get bigger muscles. Bodybuilding, for example, the goal is hypertrophy. Hypokinesia is having insufficient amount of movement, and hypotonia is having an insufficient muscle tone. And intermittent claudication is attacks of severe pain and lameness caused by muscle ischemia, usually in calf muscles. So muscle ischemia is lack of blood flow to the muscle, and then lameness, if you're lame, you can't use that muscle, that leg, with severe pain. Myalgia is muscle pain. Myasthenia is muscle weakness. Myotonia is muscle tone. Spasm is a sudden involuntary strong muscle contraction. And tenodynia is tendon pain. So let's go over the pathology terms. Fibromyalgia is a condition with widespread aching and pain in the muscles and soft tissue. Lateral epicondylitis is inflammation of the elbow muscles. It is caused by strong gripping, and it is often referred to as tennis elbow. Muscular dystrophy is an inherited disease with progressive muscle atrophy. Myopathy or myopathy, probably myopathy is better, general term for muscle disease. Myorexis is tearing of a muscle. Necrotizing fasciitis is an infection that results in the death of soft tissue. It's kind of scary looking, often caused by streptococcus. Polymyositis is an inflammation of two or more muscle. This can also be an autoimmune disease. Pseudohypertrophic muscular dystrophy is a type of inherited muscular dystrophy. It is also called Duchenne's muscular dystrophy. Torticolis is a French word that means severe neck. It's a severe neck spasm that pulls the head to one side. It is wry neck or crick in the neck. The carpal tunnel syndrome, it's a repetitive motion disorder where you get compression of the finger tendons and median nerve as they pass through the carpal tunnel of the wrist. So right here around the wrist. This happens in people that do a lot of computer typing, a lot of repetitive manual work. A ganglion cyst is a cyst on a tendon sheath, usually on the hand, wrist, or ankle. And a repetitive motion disorder is a group of chronic disorders that involve the tendon, muscles, joints, and nerve damage. The tissue is subjected to pressure, vibration, or repetitive movements, and that's what causes the damage over time. And then the last slide, we have rotator cuff injury. A joint capsule of the shoulder joint is reinforced by tendons. A high degree of flexibility puts the rotator cuff then at risk for strain and tearing. So it's the rotator cuff is the injury that we refer to usually has to do with the shoulder injury. A strain is a damage to the muscle, tendon, or ligaments that is due to overuse or overstretching. And then lastly, tendonitis is the inflammation of a tendon. I've got another video, just one more on all the diagnostic and therapeutic procedures, and I'll see you there.